Hello, in today's video, I'm going to show you the SciTech DataXchange data entry screen. A lot of our customers tell us that the value from the system comes from tracking downtimes and downtime reason codes. We can collect some downtimes from your machines automatically, but there are a lot of downtimes that a human needs to tell us. And this is the interface that they're going to use. So let's go over what we're looking at here. I have got this screen set up to show three different machines. So maybe this would be in a cell of three machines. This application will run on a PC, Windows tablet, Android, or iPad. The interface will look exactly the same no matter which interface you're running it on. But if I want to enter a downtime, it's really easy. I just choose which machine I want to control. So the EDM at the top here, it's going to show me that I am controlling the EDM. Over here on the right, it's going to show me a little bit about the status of what's going on with that machine right now, what status it's in, how long it's been in that status. So if I want to put, for instance, an unplanned downtime, I would click that button and I would get a drop-down list. This list is user definable. You can have as many reason codes as you want, but maybe I'm having a quality issue. I can just highlight that reason code and hit start new status, and instantly the database sees the new status and starts collecting time against that. You'll see the color here has changed. Each of these colors represents the current status of that particular machine. I can have planned downtimes, such as break, setup, maybe tear down. I have an in-cycle button. This is really only used if you're manually tracking cycle time. In most cases, we're actually going to get the cycle time from your machine automatically, but perhaps you have a manual process that you want to track. So maybe you could have a cycle time called inspection, and a human could just push a button to start a timer to say they're inspecting parts. Part number. We can import your part numbers from your ERP system, and somebody could go in here and type that they're looking for a specific part number. It'll filter it down. They can choose the part number, start new status. Now, any time that we collect will be applied to that part number. We could collect the part counts from some machines, but if we can't, then they could manually enter a part count here. You can enter your scrap reasons and scrap count. So you plug in your number and then you have reason codes for your scrap. Again, completely user definable. Custom commands. This is used for things such as emailing. We might have an email in the system called email maintenance. So there'd be a pre-canned email where the operator could just hit this button, say enter, and an email would be sent off to maintenance and they would know that the EDM just requested maintenance. And that concludes this overview of the data entry screen.